Great. So today, Rajendra, will be basically we'll be starting something called as exploratory data analysis. We, in short, we define it as EDA. I want people to respond for any questions or any doubts. Okay, so we call it as EDA in short. It is called as exploratory data analysis. Exploratory data analysis. Okay, what you people did with respect to NumPy, pandas, and visualization? Why is it actually very important? Is what I'll be telling you in today's session. Okay, here I want to give a credit to Kaggle, because I took the data set and the code in Kaggle actually, which was very important. I felt it was very interesting data, and the analysis was done very beautifully. So I just took the same example from Kaggle. As I told you, people can log into Kaggle and looking for the same information. I'll try to explain you what is exactly EDA in this session. Okay, I'm importing two important packages called as NumPy and pandas here, where NumPy is used to do some linear algebra, as you know, something with respect to mathematical functions. Pandas is used to do data processing. This is what we understood in the previous class. Okay. Now I'll be reading one of the important packages called as matplotlib.pyplot. If I can ask you a question, we have two important packages to do visualization. What are those?
Matplotlib.
Other one is
Seaborn.
Fantastic. One is matplotlib, other one is Seaborn, are the two important packages to do visualization. We imported both the two packages. Okay, I'm importing something called as warnings. Warning in terms of while running some code, if you get some warnings, it will be like around 5-10 lines of warnings. I say, even though I get warning, please don't show them to me. So I say filter warnings and ignore. Great. Now I'll be reading one of the file called as studentperformance.csv. This is one of the file what I'll be reading it today. It is called as studentperformance.csv. And I'll be telling you what are the steps actually required to work on data analysis, or when I say EDA. Okay, EDA is a very important task actually. Whenever I say data has to be done with analysis, EDA is very important. I'll just show you a presentation here. Can you see the presentation on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Good. Yes, sir.
So when I say the data analytics, okay, data analytics basically we're having something like business understanding. The most important thing is business understanding. We need to understand our business. Okay, what is the business all about? Whether you're working on the banking organization, working on the finance, or working for the education organization, what exactly you're working for? We need to understand the business first. Then we need to understand the data. Understand the data in terms of collect the data, describe the data, explore the data, then verify the data. Correct? What do you mean by collect the data? Collecting the data in terms of you need to take the data wherever it is present, either from the front-end technology, you store the data in the database, take the data from the database and start doing analysis. That is collecting the data. Describing the data. Describing the data is what people learn doing in pandas, where I want you people to put like around 20-30 questions on yourself and try to understand your data. That is describing the data. Explore the data. You need to understand what is there in your data, what not is there in your data, what is the extra information you need for the data. It is called as exploring the data. Then verifying the data. Verifying the data in terms of whether data is proper or not for analysis. This is verifying the data. So this is a different step for any analytical model. We say understand the business first, then understand the data, then prepare the data how you want, then do a machine learning model, evaluate it, then deploy it. Now we are in a phase where I have given a data set to you and I'm telling you as an analyst, as a business analyst, as a data analyst, I want you to understand the data and tell me your insights about the data. That would be today's agenda. Okay. For this, I'm taking an example with respect to a student data. Okay. It is respect to student data, which is a very important data actually, which was very interesting. Can you see my Google Chrome, Jupyter Notebook screen?
No, sir.
Okay. I'll just share. Fine. So now can people see the Jupyter screen?
Yeah. No, sir.
No?
Yeah.
Can you see my Jupyter? Yeah. So now I'll be reading a file called as studentperformance.csv and putting in a data DF in a data frame. Now what I want to do is, this is the data what I actually have. I'm just doing df.head. Okay. Total data. I'll read the file for you once again. I'll be importing the packages. I'll import this package. I'll import this. Then I'll import the data frame. I'll import the data frame pd.read_csv studentperformance.csv. It has already been present here. studentperformance.csv. I'm reading the same file. Okay. I'll try to read that file. Okay. Now we'll see. Then I'll add a new tab. I'll do df.head. I'll do here. I'll just do df.head. I need to understand what is there in my data. So I'll just do df.head. So you know df.head function, right? What head function will do? Head function will return the first 5 rows of the data, correct?
First five values.
Yeah, even the first five values in your data. So we'll do df dot head and I'll check. It's taking some time. We'll just see to it. Okay. So what we did in pandas, I want people to revise all those things once again, because what I will be doing in panda, what I'll be doing visualization is very important to do data analysis. Okay. I'll just do df dot head. I have something like gender, race, parent level of education, lunch, test preparation score, math score, reading score, and writing score. This is the data what is present for me. Okay. I have the student's gender. What is his race? And what are the parents' education? And what is the lunch they have daily? And the preparation course. What is the course they have taken? Whether they have completed the test or not. I mean preparation course. And after what is it? What is the score they did in mathematics? What is the reading capability and what is the writing capability? This is what they have given for us. Now I need to understand this school's students, you know, analysis. Mean to say that I need to understand what about the student in this particular school. Okay. If I want to do this, we do something called as EDA, exploratory data analysis. Okay. For doing EDA, we use visualization and we use our NumPy pandas. Taking help of NumPy pandas and visualization, we try to understand our data. Okay. Roll it me, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now the first thing what I do here is I felt okay. I have gender, race, parent level, lunch, math score, reading score, writing score. I need to understand what is their total score. What is the total score they made? Okay, I have math score, reading score, and writing score. I need to add one more column called as total score. Okay. Now I'll define one more column by name as total score. Then I define something like this. Df of total score is equal to df of math score plus df of reading score plus df of writing score. Is it correct?
Yes,
yes. So I am adding a new column by name total score. In the total score, I'm adding the math score, reading score, and the writing score together. I'm extracting df of math score plus df of reading score plus df of writing score, and I'm putting in total score. Now my total score is present. Now when I do df dot head, okay, when I do df dot head, you can see something like total score, correct?
Yeah.
Yes. Now I need to understand whether what is categorical data, which is continuous data, to do my visualization to understand the data. I am doing some command called as df dot info. Now when I do df dot info, I'll get which is categorical data and which is continuous data. Okay, I'll just run this. I'll understand how many categorical data are there in this data set.
Five categorical
data are there, four continuous data are there. How can you say the data is categorical when I have object type of data? We call it as categorical. When I have int or float, we call it as continuous.
Continuous.
Okay, so I have like four continuous data and five categorical data. Yes, we are done. Now okay. I'm converting this math score to floating value. Because usually whenever I take a number, whenever I take the mark, it would be the floating values, right? Something like 99.5, 99.2. So it will be a floating value, right? So I can do something like converting the particular column to floating value. How it can be done? How it can be done is df pd dot numeric df of max score downcast equal to float. That is, I'm converting to the floating value. Okay. When I convert to the floating value, then what I do? I'll just try to run the code once again. Okay. I'll just run this and run the code. So I'll get the max as a floating value. It is 72.0, 69.0. Previously, it was not 72.0. It was just 72. Correct. This is 72. But I am getting 72.0. That is, I am telling you one more option of converting the integer value to floating value. We can do something like this. PD dot to numeric df equal to max score downcast equal to float. Now what I'll do is I'll add one more row here. I'll add one more row and I do df dot info. I'll see if there are any changes which has been done. I'll just run this. Okay. What it says previously, max score was what?
Integer.
It has been converted to
float.
Good. Okay. So that's what we did. If you can ask me why you are doing so, I'll tell you later. I mean, now doing analysis. See, someone has given my data set to you. Someone has given, some school people have given the data set to me. And they are asking me to do analysis and give it back. They want to understand how the students are. They just give the data. This is what usually in industry the people will do, right? They give you the data set and say, start doing analysis and tell me what exact information you can give. You use your machine learning, you do your data science, you do visualization. We are not bothered about it. We want to understand about our students. That is what is our project. So we are taking care of it. Now give that given the data set to me and I'm trying to analyze about the students. Okay, I'm trying to do different things. First of all, I created one more column called as total score and I converted its math score to float. Okay, now what I'm doing is I'm trying to find out what is the average mathematics score in the entire school. Is that important for us? Okay, I want to understand what is the average mathematics score in the entire school. Okay, what is the average reading score in the entire school? What is the average writing score in the entire school? What is the average total score in the entire school? Okay, I mean, if I just wanted to do that, we have function in pandas. What is it?
Mean.
Fantastic. We have mean function. So what I do is we have in NumPy, okay, not for pandas, in NumPy. We have something we can do in pandas also. We can use describe and do, it is not a matter. But anyways, average math score is, I am telling dot format np dot mean of df of math score. Okay, np dot format df of reading score. np dot mean df of writing score. Then I am telling total score divided by 3 is the average total score. Now when I do this, I'll be getting what is the average score in the data. Oh, fantastic. See, I'll go to the plot later. You'll just see average mathematics score in this school is 66. Average reading score in this school is 69. Average writing score is 68. Average score 60. Is around somewhere around 67.7. Would you agree?
Yes, sir.
See how I'm getting information. They just gave me the students' data. I'm trying to slice the things. I'm trying to open step by step by step. I'm trying to open the data and trying to understand the students' data. This is what we are doing. I'm not using something new. I'm using something which you people already learned. You people know how to exact the mathematics score. This was a part of pandas. Are you with me, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, everyone. Praveen, Rohit, Vikas.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good, good. Okay, so now actually we understood, like, you know, we are trying to give that, just given the data set to us, what all we use in our NumPy panda functions and visualization functions, we are revisiting it and try to understand the students' data. This is what we are trying to do here. Okay, I understood. Okay, now I can give a report to the school telling it as, ma'am, in your school, the mathematics average is somewhere around 66. You need to improve in that. Okay, reading score is so and so. Writing score is so and so. Okay, fine. And I'm giving one more level of visualization. Okay, this is just, I'm not using any visualization till here. I'm using one more level of visualization where I'm using something called as subplot. You people followed subplot that day? When I say 1, 4, 1, what it means?
First matrix, 4 columns and first figure.
Fantastic. 1, 4, 1 mean to say there is 1 row, 4 columns and
first figure.
1 row, 4 columns, second figure. 1 row, 4 columns, third figure. I'm not even 1, 4, 4, I just did till 3. Okay, I'm using something called as violin plot, which is there in seaborn. As I told you, we have n number of plot to do so. We have n number of plot. I'm using something called as violin plot. Okay, when I use the violin plot, okay, I will get the output something like this, where I'll just show you what would be the output. Okay, good. I got an output. Fine. Can you people tell me what is the inference you can give seeing this visualization?
So it has a box plot in it, and
I'm not worried about the, you know, inside, I mean, what is there inside it. I'm just telling what is the analysis you can give the thing, these three figures. You have math score, reading score, writing score. What is the analysis you can give?
They are in the average of 60 to 80.
60 to 70.
No, sir, it is showing only for maths.
You are telling only for maths.
Yeah.
Only form. So you mean to say in the mass, okay, in the mass, more number of people are scoring somewhere around 65. Would you agree?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Good. Yes, sir.
This is what I can say. More number of people in mathematics are somewhere between 65, because in the violin plot, more number of data has been expended here. This violin is extended here. Correct. Then I can say.
Yes, sir.
Then I can say in reading score, more number of people are scoring somewhere around 70. Would you agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Correct. Okay, when it comes to writing score, more number of people are somewhere around 70. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Yes, this is the inference I can give. I can tell, ma'am, in your school, most of the people are good in reading. Can I give this analysis?
Yes, sir.
Good. I can say you people in your school, the people are less average, the people are scoring less in mathematics. Can I say this? Yes.
Yes.
Compared to reading, writing and mathematics, they are weak in mathematics. They are good in reading. They are average in writing. Yes, this is what analysis I can give.
Yeah, correct.
Yes, good. Okay. Now we'll go for the next one. Okay, I am putting one more plot here. I say figure size 1, I am using subplot again. 1, 3, 1 mean to say 1 row, 3 column. 1, 3, 1, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 3. Okay. I'm telling, I'm putting somewhere like bar plot. You people are very clear about bar plot now, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
In a bar plot, what I'm doing is in the x-axis, I'm doing the best preparation course. In y-axis, I'm doing the mathematics score. Data, what I'm using the DF, the same data, what I use there. Hue equal to gender. I'll tell you what is this hue. Okay. Palette equal to summer. Mean to say it is one of the design. They have n number of design. If you want, you can go to help of SNS, help of Seaborn. There you can, in the Seaborn package, you have different palettes what you can use. I'm using the summer palette here. Okay. Good. I'm doing three bar plots. One bar plot is used to do something with respect to mathematics score, with respect to test preparation course. Okay. Reading score with respect to test preparation course. Okay. Writing score with respect to test preparation course. If you ask me, what is this test preparation course? Test preparation course is before they take the test. Okay, before they take the test, okay, they are actually given some unit test, something like, preliminary test. Okay, we call it as something like round test, no? Before taking the final exams, we have a round test, right?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
I'm asking them like what is the test you have taken? You have like test number preparatory 1, preparatory 2, preparatory 3 and the final exam. Whether you have taken preparatory 2 or you have taken preparatory 3 or you have taken preparatory 1 and what is your marks? I'm trying to analyze whether the test preparation course, what they have taken, is affecting their marks. Will that be good? If you do the analysis like this, will that be good or not?
No, sir.
Okay. For example, I can say, okay, see, you have taken preparatory number 1. Okay. Then preparatory number 1 is affecting your final exam score. I don't know. I need to see. So I'm just trying to analyze. I'll run this. If you can understand, it's taking some time. Okay. See, I got it. I got test preparation course. Have you completed the test preparation course? None and completed. See? Okay. If you have completed the test preparation course, we had given you a few questions before the exams. Have you taken that course? If you have taken that course, then what is your marks? If you have not taken that score, what is your marks? Is what I am trying to tell you. Can you give an analysis with respect to mathematics score and the test preparation course? I told you I did HUE, hue equal to gender. When I say hue equal to gender, I'm putting this male and female in color. Are you following?
Yes,
in the x-axis and y-axis, x-axis is the test preparation course, y-axis is the marks what they have scored. Inside, I can put one more value which is called as hue, that is on gender. Okay, so that is what you mean to say. X-axis, y-axis is done, sir. I want to take one more characteristic. How to take? Put it in hue. I put it hue equal to gender. Yes, it's done. Now, can you give an analysis with respect to mathematics score? What is analysis? Anyone?
Who has neither completed any of the thing is male as the maximum ratio. In math score.
She is telling one analysis where she said that more number of males have taken the, they have been completed the
course. I have not taken.
No. Completed.
Scored exam.
Okay. More number of males has completed. Okay. More completed.
No, sir. They have completed and some of them are not completed.
You mean to say males have scored more score in mathematics? And
yes,
and they have completed the course. But can I give one analysis here? Can I give one analysis? I can say here as the people who have completed the test have scored more than people who have not completed the test. Will that be clear?
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
In the entire data, whether it may be mathematics score or reading score or writing score, people who have taken the test have scored more than people who have not completed the test.
Yeah.
Will you agree, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
One analysis I can give for them. I can give to the school. I can say, ma'am, people who are the students who you have given the questions and they have taken the questions and they completed it, they have scored more. People who have not completed the test have scored less. This is one of the beautiful analysis of what I can give. Would you agree?
Yes, sir.
Correct. Good. Okay. So this makes sense. Then I can give one more. Can I give one more analysis here? I can say people have taken maths test more than compared to reading and writing test.
Yes.
Would you agree for that?
Yes, sir.
Yes. In all the cases, yes, I can say male strength is more and female strength is less. Would you agree for this?
Yes, sir.
Now I can take one more analysis. I can take, sir, what is the ratio between the male and the female? You people can do it. Correct, no? You people can do. Okay. If there are around 100 students, how many people are male? How many people can female? You can compare.
Yes, sir.
That can be done. Great. Okay. This was one more analysis. What we did. We are exploring the data. See, this is very, very interesting and important. This is what I say, right? Data analytics and data science is very interesting. But you must know how to make it interesting. Okay, then I have taken one more called as pair plot. Do you people remember the pair plot? Okay, I'll be telling you, this is our pair plot. Okay, what we do in this pair plot is, I'm using the seaborne package, SNS or pair plot, and I'm taking the same data, I'm taking U equal to gender. And I'm trying to construct a pair plot. We will see how the pair plot will be constructed. This is a very important plot, and this is very interesting. Okay, can I see this particular pair plot? I have something like gender, female and the male. The dark color corresponds to female and the light color corresponds to male. Can you see here?
Yes, sir.
Dark color responds to female and the light orange color corresponds to male. That is one thing. I'm trying to compare math score, reading score, writing score, total score to math score, reading score, writing score, total score. I'm trying to compare each other. I'll do one thing now. What I do now is, I'll try to understand how is reading score and the mathematics score are related. Try to understand. I'll just minimize the screen for your understanding. What I'll do now is.
So what is that KWS, sir?
Just a moment, I'll come.
Okay,
see, it's one of the parameter. It is one of the parameter for the plot, for the visualization perspective. Okay, it's a parameter for the plot, for the visualization perspective. Okay, you can try with the help of pair plot so that you'll be understanding, okay, what are the different options you have. You can make the, you know, design more beautiful. Okay, I'm trying to make it more legible. I'm using alpha value as 0.2. Okay. So you can just revise that, like how to change the value and what happens when you change the alpha value to different cents. Okay.
Fine. Okay, sir.
But it's one of the parameter for the design perspective. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Great. Now, can you people make an observation here? This is a mathematics score. This is a reading score. This is a writing score, and this is a total score. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Can you see here? It is a mathematics score and the mathematics score. This is a mathematics. I'll take this reading score. How a reading score is related to mathematics score? This is math score. This one is math score.
Yes,
everyone,
sir,
agree?
Yeah.
This is the reading,
yes,
score.
Yes,
everyone,
sir,
agree? The second column, reading score.
Yes,
I can say, mm-hmm, that if the reading score is increasing, the mathematics score is also increasing.
Yes.
Yes. Correct. Yes, I can say that if the writing score is increasing, the mathematics score is also increasing. Yes.
Yes, sir.
If the test score is increasing, the mathematics score is also increasing. Yes. So this analysis I can give here. Okay, I can say, when you can take any score for that matter, all the score is related. I can say this is increasing. It is increasing trend. Either we can do increasing trend. See, you can just see my cursor. If something is rising like this, it is an increasing trend. If it is coming something like this, it is decreasing trend. Correct? It's coming from here to it is decreasing trend. When I go here, it is an increasing trend. And there is no trend at all. The data will be everywhere scattered. If there is a relationship between each other, the data will be scattered everywhere. But in this case, it's not happening actually. You can see the data is very much, you know, it is together and it is increasing. Would you agree?
Yeah, increasing. Yes.
Oh, good. Yeah, that makes sense. This is one of the analysis what I can tell for them. Mean to say that everything is related to each one another. Can I say this analysis for them? Yes. Good. Okay. Now I'll take. Now I see something like food. I am having a doubt. The students who are having the food actually matters for the way how they study. I got this doubt. What the food they take is related to how they study. Do you think is that related?
Yes.
So question for you people.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let us see. Let us see. I don't know. Even I don't know. I thought it was interesting. So I try to do that. Is the food affecting the course? First of all, I need to understand what are different kind of food they are taking. There are two different type of thing. You remember using unique function?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So unique said me that it has standard and the free. We have two type of food. Okay, the standard food and the free food. Okay. Now I'm trying to understand whether they are having the food. See, this is what the analysis I got. Okay, I'll just add. Just a moment. Yes. See, I'm preparing here bar plot. I say test preparation course. Y-axis is the match score. There actually the U was gender. You remember H U was gender. U was gender. Here U is lunch.
Yes, sir.
U is lunch. Yeah. I'm putting so inside that x-axis, y-axis is done. Inside that lunch will come inside. Lunch will come inside the color. So when I see this, can you make any analysis here?
Yes.
What is the analysis?
Standard lunch. Okay.
Standard food itself is more.
More,
I
sir.
Mean, people consume more.
Fantastic.
So people consuming more standard lunch.
Food. Very good. The people consuming the more standard food, the more they score. Correct?
More than score. Yes, sir.
Very good. This was analysis. See, we didn't know. We can tell our school. We can tell to the school telling it as, ma'am, the food actually matters for their score. Will you agree?
Yeah.
Yes.
Sir. Yeah. People
are taking less nutrition food or they're taking free food. They're not able to concentrate. I mean to say they might be less in the nutrition so that they might be not having the concentration or memory. So these people are not able to score more. But the other kind of students are having the standard food and they're actually scoring well. Correct? See? How beautiful it is. And I'm not using anything new. Can you see this? And can you see the code? See what all I taught, the same thing I'm using. I'm not using anything new. You people I taught you subplot, correct?
Yes, sir.
I have taught you bar plot, correct?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
You know how to put the title, correct? That is what I'm using here. But you must know how to put and where. That is what I told you, we need to practice. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, so this is what we did. Okay, now what we do next one is, okay, like I want to know only the toppers. How can I say they are toppers?
If we will set a certain mark, sir, particular marks, we will set a target.
Yeah,
if there is
very good, very good. So I can say the people have scored more than 90, they are toppers, toppers. So I'll just take all the people who have scored more than 90 and just, I'll just run. I'm sorted it in the descending order. That is the topmost people will come at the first. You know, I taught you sort values. Will you agree?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sort values. Correct. Yes. So sort values I'm doing ascending equal to false, mean to say it would be in the descending order. Correct.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Oh, fantastic. Now I have something like this. There are somewhere around 20-25 people who are called as toppers in this school. Okay. The first topper is register number 962. The second topper is register number 458.
Yes.
Correct. Can you make any analysis in this? Yes. I want you people to take this first two, 962 and 458. What is the analysis people can make these people? This is a very good, interesting observation people can do for these two people.
They are in the lunch when they are having the standard food only.
Fantastic.
Sir.
There's one observation.
And females are
and
the
they,
females.
Their
the both.
Is
good. They're females.
They
yes.
belong. They belong to same race group E.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Then.
And they have the
same scores even. The same scores. Yeah.
Very important is test preparation course. They have not taken the test.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right?
Yeah.
They are not. So, I was very happy seeing this in Kaggle. Okay, this data, because they are not taken the test and they are toppers. Correct. So, what's the analysis? I can say to the school telling it as, ma'am, there's two analysis. One is these two people are very genius or they did some malpractice. Correct. Would you agree? Correct. Because if they're not taken the test and they're scoring that, the toppers mean to say there might be something like, you know, something like Amir Khan in Three Idiots. Okay. Because they're not taken the test and they're not, they're toppers of the school, mean to say that either they got some question paper in the previous day, they tried to mug it, or they're very genius, they don't attend the test, but still they're able to do the better.
Yeah.
Correct? This is an example I can give. Then I can filter people, I can filter all the people who have not taken the test preparation course, I can filter all the none, and I can group, I can call them and ask, how come you people have not taken the test and were able to score to the best? Can I do that?
Yeah.
Yes, this analysis.
Yes, sir.
Good. Then, here one more thing is, okay, this is what is the analysis, what I was able to do. If I give an option, what else you can do? What else analysis you people can do? I'm just using NumPy. I'm not using statistics here for your information. I'm not using any statistics. I'm not using the, you know, left skewed or right skewed, nothing. It's just the NumPy, Pandas and visualization. That's it. I'm just using Seaborn and Matplotlib. Not more than that. I'm asking you what best analysis you can do. I did till here. I want everyone here, everyone in this classroom, I want you people to answer what analysis you people can do in this data. Anyone can take an opportunity, anyone can get a chance. I want everyone to answer.
We can analyze.
We can take the parent level of education.
Very good. Someone told me parent level of education. Who is it? Manoj?
So how many people? It's like
Vikas?
Bachelor degree associate.
Uh-huh. Vikas good. So you need to say that
bachelor's degree or
yeah. Very good, fantastic, very good analysis. So Vikas told that, can I take the parent level of education to compare how the student is studying? Good. Next, Lekha.
So even we can divide them into groups, sir. One is the topper, average student, and the low, I mean below average student, and we can analyze what makes them below average.
Fantastic. Okay, she made to say now she'll start grouping with respect to the level of education, how much they're studying. Good. Rohit.
Sir, I couldn't hear the question, sir. Can you please repeat it?
I want you to do your own analysis. Till now I did my analysis. If you given an opportunity to do the further analysis, what analysis you can do in this data? Lekha told she will clarify, she'll make the group as group A, group B, group C, the average people, very good people, and the brilliant people, something like that. Then she start analysis. And Vikas told he will do parent level of education, then he will do. He will ask like bachelor to parent, have the bachelor or associate degree, then he start doing analysis. What you can do?
Sir, here two things we can do, sir. One is with the total, and the other thing is with the lunch, whatever they have prepared, they'll be giving, sir.
Okay. We did this already, right? We did the with respect to lunch and the total. Okay. You want to especially take the total score and the lunch only alone? Yes.
Yes,
that's
sir.
Okay. Good.
Sir, then we can analyze that ratio, sir, by taking how many have completed and how many have not completed. By that, we can get to know, is this necessary, that test preparation courses?
Yeah, because we did it already, right?
But we can take the ratio, no, sir. If
good.
We get the
yes.
ratio.
Fantastic. You can take the ratio. Yes. Great. Good. Praveen, any answers?
No, sir. Thank you.
No. I can say, you people didn't point out me with respect to ethnicity. We can take the ethnicity. Whether they are from which race, whether they are the blacks or whites, or what exactly that. Based on the ethnicity also, we can try to compare. That can be done. Ethnicity with respect to race.
And also taking the math score, reading score, and writing score. So in which of the subject they're scoring better, and
very
how
good.
To improve in other subjects.
Exactly. We can find out whether they have a reading ability good or writing ability good or mathematics they are good. So that we can try, if the person is very good in reading ability, then I'll stop writing him. I mean, I'll say that, okay, you stop writing and from now on just start reading, so that you'll be grasping more in reading. I can do that also, and I can improve his education. Correct?
Yeah.
Great, man. See, this is what actually we can do with respect to EDA. This is expert data analysis. You people were thinking why we are learning NumPy, why we are learning Pandas, why we are learning visualization. Correct. This is advantage. This is what we do. Given any data set, we can do like this, and we will give information. The next level of education, next level of thing is we can do machine learning models and we can do statistics, then machine learning on top of it.
Okay.
Good. Is it making sense, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Fine. I already forwarded this to the classroom. I want you people to take it very seriously today. Revise it. Already you'll be getting the video, recorded video one more time. Okay. I want you people to visualize the video one more time and try to analyze. And I want everyone to give your own analysis on the different data set where I'll be forwarding you as an assignment today. I want everyone to do that. Will that be okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Great. I see who can do the best. I see who can do that. And the next class would be you people will be given an opportunity for 5 minutes for everyone. For first 5 minutes, everyone have to actually tell me and show your screen and display what best you have did. Okay, can you do it?
Sir, I have a doubt, sir. Will you please repeat what is Palato when we use that?
Palato is one of the theme. It is one of the theme what we are using it. It's a color theme. Okay, you can use different themes. It's just a theme. Okay.
Okay,
great.
Sir.
Great. Okay. I want you people to do it. Okay. Fine. So we'll be having the class next time and tomorrow, and we can continue. Great. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.